हेलो फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज अनिल राज। वेलकम टू विट्स कनेक्ट। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स। यस, स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटेरियल्स इज अ मेजर सब्जेक्ट। इन दिस यू आर हैविंग टू यूनिट्स, वन इज डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम्स वन एंड डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम्स टू विल प्ले ए मेजर रोल इन योर फाइनल एग्जाम्स, बिकॉज मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ मार्क्स आर गोइंग टू कम अंडर दिस डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम्स। सो बाई द वीडियोज वी विल सॉल्व ऑल द केसेस एज वेल एज ऑल द प्रॉब्लम्स बिलोंग्स टू स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ मटीरियल्स। लेट अस सी, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू गो फॉर डिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ बीम्स, फर्स्ट यू नीड टू नो द स्ट्रेंथ एंड स्टिफनेस ऑफ द मटीरियल्स। येस, बिफोर गोइंग फॉर द डिफ्लेक्शंस यू हैव टू नो स्ट्रेंथ एंड stiffness. So what is strength and what is stiffness? So let's see. Strength is the resistance to external load which is against failure. We're coming to the stiffness. Stiffness is the defined as the resistance against the deformation. So you're having two concepts, each looks similar, but the concept is very simple. Strength tells us how much amount of load the beam is going to take within the elastic limit. How much amount of load the beam is going to take within the elastic limit comes under strength. But stiffness, the resistance against deformation, it means the beam should not deform much. So when the beam is deforming much, then what happens? The beam is going to be failure. So there it should have some stiffness. Let me tell you one more example. A person who is playing cricket. So generally we all play cricket. A person who is playing cricket has to stay in the ground for 25 to 50 overs sometimes. Because he should have his strength, he should have his stiffness, he should have a flexibility. Because going to the ground, it doesn't mean. But staying for 50 overs with the same energy of potentials in the field brings out his stiffness and flexibility. Yes. So in the same way, whatever the beams which you are taking, that should have strength as well as stiffness. Today's class, we are going to see about deflection of beams. How the beams are going to be deflected and what are the methods that are going to be described in the deflection of beams. Because for polytechnic guys, this is major concept, and for the BTech students also, deflection of beams is must. So let us see all the concepts very clearly, right? Let us see some of the examples. For example, I am taking a simply supported beam. This is A, this is B. I am having two ends. This is simply supported. Here, a W is the load which is acting at the center. So W is the load which is acting at the center. Let this point be C. Then this beam is going to deflect. How the shape of deflection will be? Like this. The beam is going to be deflect like this. In case of a simply supported beam. While coming to the problems, we are going to discuss what will be the deflection, under how much load, how much it is deflecting, and what is the angle which is making with the tangent of this. This is called as theta. So we'll call as slope as well as deflections. How much it is going to be deflected, what will be the slope of this. So these are the concepts which will come in your problems. So let us see if simply support beam which is in these directions. Now let us see, in case of simply support, it is like this. In case of continuous, the concept is like this. What is a continuous beam? A beam which is having more than two supports is called as a continuous beam. A, B, C. Here I am giving two loads. So this is W1, this is W2. Here W1 and W2 are the loads which I am giving at the span AC and BC. Now let's see how the deflection comes. So the deflection will be like this. Deflection will be like this. So you will get the deflection like this, and you will be having one more beam. What is that beam? It is continuous beam. This is simply support beam. Next is overhanging beam. What is an overhanging beam? When the beam is extended beyond the support, we'll call it as overhanging beam. These overhanging beams are also divided into two types. One is single overhanging, one is double overhanging. Let us see double overhanging beam, how the deflection diagram will be. So like this. So this is my beam, and here are my supports. So this is A, this is B. The beam is overhanging to left and the beam is overhanging to its right. Now let us see the loads which are coming over here. Right. Now we'll see how the deflection takes place. So the deflection will be going to take place like this. This is in case of overhanging beams. And let us see one more example, that is cantilever beam. Why I wrote like this, in the sense, in the case of easy understanding, if a beam is supported by two supports, it is called as a simply supported beam. If the beam is supported more than two supports, it is called as a continuous beam. If a beam overhangs more, beyond the supports, it is called as overhanging beams. So let us see the concept of cantilever beams. So this is the fourth case. We'll call it as a cantilever beam. So this will be A. This will be, B. You're having two support, one single support which is fixed at that end. So let us see how the beam is going to be deflected. Here W is the load which is acting at the free end, and the beam is going to be deflected like this. Right? So here comes your deflection. So that is the deflection of your beam. And you are having one more beam. What is that beam? It is called as a fixed beam. Right? Let's see what is fixed beam. See, when the beam is supported with single support, with single what we call a fixed support, is called as a cantilever beam. And when the beam is having two fixed support at both ends, it is called as a fixed beam. So fixed beam. So here is my load W, and the deflection is like this, like this, like this, and like this. See, in case of simply supported, so the deflection started from the support, but in case of fixed support, the deflection didn't carry it towards the fixed support. Because of the fixed movements and reactions, the beam will restrain the failure of the beam to L by 4th and L by 4th of this. For example, if it is L, and the deflection will take place in between L by 2, and L by 4 is restricted by the fixed support. Right? Let us see one more beam. What is the next beam? That beam is called as propped cantilever beam. What is a propped cantilever beam? A beam whose one end is fixed and other end is propped is called as a propped cantilever beam. So this is the sixth type of beam. So one will be fixed and other will be propped. So here I am writing P in the sense prop. So when my load acts at this point, when W is acting at the proper side at the P point, then my deflection will be, diagram will be like this. So actually that should be like this, but what happened due to the prop, the deflection got reduced at the end. Now let us see once all the six concepts fixed, simply support beam. A beam whose both ends are simply supported at its ends is called as a simply supported beam. Continuous beam. A beam who is having more than two supports is called as a continuous beam. Overhanging beam. A beam whose beam whose length of the beam is extended beyond the supports is called as overhanging beam. These overhanging beams are divided into two types. One is single overhanging, next is double overhanging. Next, let us see cantilever beam. A cantilever beam is a type of beam whose one end is fixed and the other end is free. Right? Now, let us see fixed beam. A fixed beam is a beam whose both ends are fixed or rigid. Now let's see proper cantilever beam. A beam whose one end is fixed and other end is propped is called as a proper cantilever beam. Why I am discussing all the things in the sense, again in the exam point of view, he'll be asking you what are the different types of beams and explain with the diagrams. The question will come to you. So there are six type of beams and these are the abbreviations which I tell you, and these are the deflections. Let us see what is the concept of slope as well as deflection and how it is going to be deflected in different types of beams. Let us see the concept of slope and deflection. What is slope? Slope at a point and a bent beam is the angle which the tangent at that point makes with the x axis. So deflection, the transverse displacement of a point on a straight axis to the curved axis is called deflection of the point. It means, I'll explain you in a simple diagram what is slope and what is deflection, what the concept is. For example, let me take you a simply supported beam AB. So a simply supported beam AB where the load W is acting on it. So how the beam is going to deflect has been discussed earlier, like this. So like this the deflection is going to be occurred. What he is saying, what is the slope in the sense? Slope at any point on the bent beam is the angle which the tangent that the point makes with the x axis. It means this is my bent beam. This is my original beam and this is my bent beam. When I draw a tangent to it, tangent in the sense actually, so this is my tangent. So if I take it as a circle, when I cut a straight line with this, then when my line is touching a circle at a single point, it is called as a tangent. Here I am having a tangent. And if you take that side also, you will get a tangent. Right? So these are the tangent. What he is saying? The angle which is making with the x-axis. The angle which is making with the x-axis is called as theta. So this is your theta. Theta is nothing but slope here. Generally, we'll write it as theta, right? Now let's see deflection. The transverse displacement of a point on straight axis to the curved axis is called as deflection. It means for this, this is the straight axis, this is the curved axis. It means the here to here, whatever the length, which is called as deflection, that is denoted with delta. Generally, theta is measured in radians because it is angle. So that's why it is measured in radians. And this deflection is always measured in mm. So, for example, the beam is, I'm having a beam of 2 meters. I'm having a beam of 2 meters. On this, a 10 kilonewtons load which is coming and acting at the center point. So, what happens in the sense? It is deflecting due to this 10 kilonewtons load. How much it is going to be deflecting in the sense? 1 mm or 2 mm. So, this is a straight one. This is a curved one. And the vertical distances between the straight axis and curved axis is called the deflection. The vertical distance between the straight axis and curved axis is called as deflections. So, this is our deflection, this is our slope. So, in this unit, definitely we are going to deal with the slopes as well as deflection, and we are having different methods to solve the slopes and deflections. Let us see what are those methods and how to solve these methods. We'll see briefly.